Geothermal energy has, in modern history, been a continuous reliable source of energy. This is because of the fact that the cost to produce it has gone down significantly, with a modernly built power plant today costs no more than 5 cents per kilowatt hour. Furthermore, geothermal is known to be sustainable and renewable as the heat extraction is small compared with the Earth's heat content. With such promises, however, there are only a few nations in the world that have access to such abundances, namely the US, Indonesia, and the Philippines. Three nations combined hold close to 60% of the world's geothermal production, the Philippines producing in 2020 around 1.9 gigawatts of energy, whereas Indonesia with 2.1 gigawatts and the US with 3.7 gigawatts. The Southeast Asian nations, however, hold far more potential in the coming years. The Philippines is seen as a strong beneficiary of this far and wide energy producing scheme. Back in the 1980s, it was known that there had been abundant and remarkable sources of geothermal energy in the Philippines, whereas it was often dubbed to be a success story. Because of the potential, the nation had consistently relied on it, and with only a few nations having access to such, it was clearly a win. By 2005, it was accounting for over 16% of the total electricity generation of the country, and the fact that it was only because of 6 geothermal fields had truly, on a large scale, been a shining moment. It is predicted that the growth of geothermal energy reliance will grow to a further 2.1 gigawatts by 2025. Even some of the oldest power plants that date their way back around the 1970s have still up to today been providing energy to tens of thousands of people every year. The future potential is clearly in sight. As technology advances, there will likely be more options to fully harness this geothermal energy. According to the Philippines Energy Plan, a 14-year scheme from 2016 to 2030, geothermal will see its capacity increase more, adding about 1.3 gigawatts by 2030, on top of the current 1.9 gigawatts of 2020. Well, anyway, what do you think about the nation's geothermal potential?